First off, I have to begin this video by saying this fish is a freaking trooper. First he gets fried by Mumbo in the beginning, and the next game he gets squished by a boulder. But anyway, hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here, we're finally back for some more Banjo-Kazooie. Aw, man, I hope that fish really escapes. But anyway, we're here to challenge bottles! I hate that sneaky mole. Oh, we're not close enough. It's a little sensitive. You gotta go above the fireplace, and there we go. Whoa! You found my secret moving picture game! Complete this puzzle and you can win a mystery prize! It better be good, Soil Brain! Do I get some new moves? Maybe. Now watch this! Oh no, he's into the light! And okay, whoa, we got like a puzzle game right here. So yes, basically, use the left stick to move Banjo's hand and press A to pick up and put the down the pieces. If it's X to return them to the side or the right side of the screen. Okay, we got it, Mumbo. Mumbo, I mean bottles! Oh man, I'm already mixing up my characters. So yeah, we got a little puzzle game right here. It's kind of cool that, Banjo-Kazooie has a little mini-game section. Pretty much puzzle gives you... Bottles gives you a series of puzzle challenges that the player must complete, and by completing them, we get certain cheats that make Banjo do pretty funny things. So, I definitely want to show off that. Hopefully I can combine the, these puzzle parts into one, and I can get the cheat section in as well, because putting it in one part will be easier. I don't feel like doing two more parts. I just want this LP to be over with, not that I'm disappointed with it, but it's just, I just want to finish it finally. I haven't completed a project in a while, so it'd be great to finally do something, and that Stop and Swap video took a lot of work to do, and I love the reception I got on. I love you guys. Love. Basically, in this part, I decided to, show the puzzles. I'm not playing it right now. I'm doing post-narration, like I said in the last part, because I'm gonna end up, this first puzzle I'm gonna show in the complete entirety, because it's more of like a tutorial in say, or per se. And the next couple puzzles I'm going to speed up, and I just thought it would be a great opportunity to just do like a little update video in this. Not to take away from the experience. Hey, you did it! It was easy, Beetle Breath! What do we win? Listen carefully and I'll tell you. Use the tiles on the floor of the sandcastle in Treasure Trove Cove to spell the word Bottles Bonus 1. And so Bottles is pretty much going to give us all these bonuses that we have to enter inside the cheat section of the sandcastle. So like I was saying, I want to do some updates right here. Basically, a lot of people have been telling me, hey, Yankee, when's Fallout going to come back? Well, I stayed like a month ago, or a couple of weeks ago, I think, in my comments section if you guys read it. I know it wasn't clear I should have made an update video, but I haven't had enough time, so here's the spill, or here's... I spilled the beans, okay. That didn't come off the tongue correctly. But anyway, the reasoning for, or not the reasoning, but Fallout 3 will continue basically sometime this week, maybe, I'm guessing like Monday maybe? Maybe late weekend, I'm not sure because I just started school like yesterday and it's been a little hectic there because my teachers went on strike. So half my classes are canceled, which is, you'd think I have more time, but it kind of gets me behind in classes because now I have to get all the notes from an outside source, and yeah, it's not good there. So that should be resolved soon, but still, I'm just saying I just started school, that's why I haven't been uploading more frequently. And with Fallout, I'm pretty much going to continue that sometime in the next couple days, so expect that. And the second piece of information I'm giving you guys is I'm sticking with this channel. I am not switching over to the Righteous Bean account that I made previously in July, I think. I was a good idea. I'm not going to say good idea, but it was something I wanted to do at the time. But then after thinking about it, I didn't want to leave all my videos behind. I've started off this channel 2 years ago. I want to finish on this channel. So I'm going to stay on this channel, and a lot of people know about it. It would have been way much too... I really cannot talk today. I guess it was a school. Gives you the brain damage. But pretty much, I didn't feel like starting a whole new process of starting up the channel. It would have taken too much work to end. Been a little too much for me to handle, so decided to ditch that effort. Not to say it was a bad one, but it was just one that I just looked in the future and was like, probably not the best idea. Alright, so that's two updates right there. Oh, and the third update, the last and final one, I believe, is a lot of people have been asking me as well what my next LP is, LP number 9. I want to get some Fallout parts out before I want to start LP number 9. I don't know if I want to do them alongside each other because I feel like Fallout 3 is dragging so bad. I know it's dragging so bad. It's been 2 months without a part. So I might do a thing where I upload Fallout like Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and upload a lot of parts in one day. I might do that. I don't know. I have to make a schedule around that because that and LP number 9. LP number 9 is going to be like, I think 40 parts, so it's a traditional game. A lot of people know about it. I might drop hints about it maybe on Twitter, which I'm going to pop up right here as an annotation because a lot of you haven't been following me on Twitter. I don't know if you have been asking me about all these updates, and I've been updating them on Twitter constantly, and a lot of people are still asking me these questions, so definitely want you guys to be aware of that. And what else do I want to say? Yeah, that's about it, I guess. Just follow me on Twitter to get updates about what's going on, about the three topics I just said. And yeah, so let's just get on with the puzzle making. And something about these puzzles, I don't know, the first couple are really easy, then when you get to the later ones, they're incredibly hard. Like, if you notice in the cuts I'm doing right now in the editing, it took me a couple tries in the later ones. Like, the one I'm working on now, or the one I worked on the last one, that one took me about, like, 10 tries. The other one took me about 5. Oh, man, those are really hard puzzles, but I guess the reward is worth it. It's not really worth it, but it's kind of funny to see that some of the transformations Banjo could turn into when you enter those codes in the sandcastle. A lot of sandcastle cheats. I don't know what was rare about that, but we all saw in Stop and Swap them in their cheats. Oh, and another question I just thought of. A lot of you are probably going to ask, am I going to LP Banjo-Tooie? Maybe, I don't know. Keep it in mind, it's out there. I'll consider it, but it's not on the list I'm trying to do right now. Like, right now I have, like, one or two games I'm going to do before, even if I would consider that. Like, right off the bat, I have two off the top of my head. So, maybe next year I'll do Tooie, or, I don't know, never say never. I always change my mind on what game's going to play, so, just know that it's an option, and, I might do in the future, so, yeah. Alright, let's see, are we almost done with this puzzle? It feels like I've been doing this forever, man. It took me forever to do all these puzzles. It probably took me like a half hour just to complete them all, because I'm not the best puzzle maker person, taker, baker, caker. Okay, moving on. Aw, oh, man, so anyway, those are all the puzzles, but wait! There's actually one more puzzle that we have to do, which I left until the end, purposely, because for some reason, Bottles doesn't say, like, there's one more puzzle. He's like, yeah, you finished. I was like, okay, wait. There's definitely another cheat I know about, but I believed him. I walked out, and I was like, okay, last one. But the only thing I noticed, or how I found out, was through my Xbox, actually, because I have all my achievements unlocked for Banjo-Kazooie, but except one, and that was completing all the puzzles. And I was like, okay, Bottles already told me I got all the puzzles. Why didn't it work? Well, I didn't do that last puzzle because he doesn't mention it. He says they're all done. And I was like, damn you, you mole, how dare you? And it made me kind of think, you know what? Not to curse or anything, or I'm part of my language, but Bottles is an asshole. I'm sorry, but he really is. Like, in the first game, he's like, okay, I'm going to teach you these moves. I'm going to be nice, I guess. But then he has all these side comments about you, and he's like, yeah, whatever. He's like, I'm going to kill you. He's like Toby from The Office. I don't know. He's not that the sense that he's like, Mike, not mad at us, but like angry toward us in his dialogue, but you could sense that everyone hates him and he's just like gonna kill everyone eventually. Oh man, in the second game, I don't want to give any spoilers, but we kind of help him. I don't know, and he's really a jerk. I don't get it. In the third game, Nuts and Bolts, he's a bigger jerk because with that stop and swap thing, if you give him 6,000 notes, he tells you about Stop and Swap, and when you try to find out what Stop and Swap was by giving the notes, he responds, then I have to kill you first. Like, come on, Bottles, what kind of mole are you, man? Oh, man. Potential serial killer, possibly rapist. I don't know. Oh, my God, I just got really off topic there, but hey, we beat the puzzle. Oh, my, that was harder than I expected. And by harder, it took me about 50 tries. 50-15, same thing. Aw, oh, man. So anyway, this is about the time that we cut away to the sandcastle where I enter those cheats that will transform Banjo into various funny different shapes and sizes. Alright, so we're back here in the sandcastle and Banjo's even doing a little dance for us. Oh, go Banjo! Go Banjo! Aw, oh, man, Kazooie just got served. But anyway, let's go ahead and type in those bottles, cheat codes. Basically, all the cheat codes are as follows. I'll just pop them up all on screen all at once right now because I'm lazy like that. So, and I'm sorry I didn't get the last cheat. I didn't feel like doing that last puzzle because it's really, really, really hard. And if you have enough free time to even do it, you're a freaking maniac because, yeah, and the cheat it gives you, it turns Banjo and Kazooie into a washing machine. Like, we won't see that again. Spoilers! Yeah. Yeah, I'll keep that in. Why not? So anyway, yes, we gotta type in this monotonous little code right here. The only thing I wish in this game was that the cheat codes were simpler. I don't know. Having to type in the same thing 100 times, and especially those stop and swap ones, weren't exactly a walk in the park and took about like a half hour for the stop and swap ones. And whoa, my God! Look at you! To change back, just type no bonus. So look at that, we're a freaking bobblehead Banjo. Look how big her head is. Look, you can put your nose in the ground and you're that freaking big. Alright, so let's see the next transformation right here. What the hell? We got freaking big arm. Look at her hands and her feet. What the hell, man? It's like Sasquatch Banjo. That looks so freaking awkward. Oh my God. It's got like elephantitis in the hands and the feet. Poor guy. Oh my God. Banjo, the Elephant Man edition. Oh God. Let's change him back. Alright, so what we got this time around? Okay, we finished. Whoa, my God, Kazooie! You've certainly gotten bigger. Look at her big. It's pretty much the Banjo bobblehead one, but this time just Kazooie's massive. And that Talontrot even looks ridiculous, look at that. Alright, what the? Jesus Christ, man, what happened to your torso? It's like the Slim Jim Banjo. Alright, it looks like a freaking, it's like a Dachshund Banjo, it's like those wiener dog things. Oh man, look how small his head is, it looks ridiculous, and even him diving. Oh man, poor Banjo, I feel bad torturing him like this. But these are the cool cheats you can get by doing that puzzle thing, so a lot of transformations and a lot of cheats in this game. And let's see, the final one is... What is the final one? Bonus? What do we got? Whoa! Okay, we got all the things by doing that one. I think that was bottles bonus 5 or something. Holy crap, so we have all of the additions given to us. Let's go outside and like explore the area with this transformation. I don't know. This might be pretty funny. Look how big we are compared to everything else. I want to see how big we are compared to Snacker. Shut up, Snacker. I defeated you. I farted on your head the last time we met. I was once yet a learner, but now I am the fart master. Oh wow, he can still hit us? Wow, I thought we'd be at least faster. I mean, look how big we are compared to the crabs. Oh my God. Imagine playing the entire game with this transformation. Jeez. That's pretty funny. You actually can, because you can get all the cheat codes after Treasure Trove Cove, so that's pretty funny that you can play the whole entire game like this. I don't know who would, but still. A large run of Banjo, I don't know. Doesn't help his attributes or anything, so it's kind of pointless. Alright, so anyway, yeah, that's the last and final transformation I'm going to show. I told you before that by doing the final puzzle, you can get the transformation of the washing machine. But I don't feel like doing that puzzle. It's really hard. I know. It took me a while to complete it. I couldn't do it. Just don't have enough time in my hands. But if you want to see it, you can just play the next game because it's in that one. So, yeah. So, yeah, I guess this is it. This is where I'm going to close off. I think we're done with Banjo-Kazooie. I've done everything I possibly can in this game. I've covered everything. I went over Stop and Swap. I beat the whole entire game. I showed off the little after-game specials you can do. So, yeah, I think this is where we wrap it up and close it out. So, wow, this LP came and went. It's because I didn't really get to talk during the credits about how this game was and my experience with it. So I was mainly just doing the voiceover, so I might as well get that over with now. It's kind of weird doing without the credits. So I'll do my best. But yeah, Banjo-Kazooie, one of my favorite games of all time. Definitely as a kid, and definitely even as a freaking 19, I'm turning 20 soon, 20-year-old. Yeah, happy pre-birthday to me if you guys are keeping track. Birthday is next weekend. Get me something nice. Give me some money, though. Come on, if you can't even give me money, you know, just give me a subscription. Why not? Okay, easy there. Anyway, so yeah, Banjo-Kazooie, one of my favorite games of all time. It probably is my favorite game of all time. It's tied with Paper Mario 1000 Year Door, so definitely one of those two. They're both equally great games. But I would have to say Thousand Year Derp. Okay. The Thousand Year Derp definitely takes the cake. Derp. So anyway, yeah, this is it. This has been my Let's Play of Banjo-Kazooie. I hope you've enjoyed it. I certainly have. So I'll see you guys next time on Let's Play Fallout 3, which I haven't played in 2 months, but I've recently practiced it. I think we're going to do fine on that. So we're going to get back to that LP and maybe do a mystery LP alongside of it. I've decided the game. You just have to figure out the hints, and I'll give you the answer. Maybe on my birthday. I don't know. I'll spill it soon. So anyway, look out for that LP coming up soon, but I'll get on with Fallout 3. I will see you guys next time. This is Yankee Gamer 5, signing out.